Congratulations, coach. You have completed chapter 2. In this chapter, we have discussed what the coaching philosophy is and why it is an important precondition for great coaching. We also explained that coaches who have a clear and well-established philosophy have clear goals and are more driven and proactive, make quicker and better decisions, build great relationships and become role models, and are better at reflecting and therefore keep improving all the time. We then made it clear that coaching is about people. It's an interpersonal and relational activity. And for this reason, any coaching philosophy, but more so if you are coaching kids, has to be built on a very solid ethical foundation. As a coach, you have to uphold the highest standards of morality and integrity. Remember, ethical coaching is not an approach to coaching, but a moral obligation. We agreed the value of having a philosophy and the need for a strong ethical footing. After that, you developed your own philosophy and your personal code of conduct. But we took it a step further and helped you go from a simple list of words to what we called action statements, the actual behaviors that become the external manifestation of your philosophy. We said that your values and beliefs set the parameters for your coaching, but that action statements bridge the gap between theory and practice. We also mentioned that the coaching philosophy is best viewed as a compass rather than as a prescriptive GPS satellite navigation system. The compass tells you where true north is, but it also gives you the choice of how to get there, the flexibility to act in the best possible way for every person and situation. Finally, we had a hard look in the mirror to see if our spoken and acted philosophies matched each other. Some of us maybe needed to recalibrate and change some of our behaviors to really live up to our own high standards of ethical behavior. But hey, that's what coaching is about: learning and getting better every day. Congrats again on completing chapter 2. Please do the quiz to see how much you took away and complete any other coursework related to this chapter. In chapter 3, we will take your personal philosophy a step further and will start thinking about how to develop your vision and strategy for your club or your team. Thanks again for being a children's coach and making such a big difference. See you soon. Keep calm and coach on!